business. Good evening, everyone. First and foremost, I would like to ask for the permission to present the case of my client who is applicant in this court in front of the Honorable Supreme Court and the judges of Supreme Court.
Permission granted. Please proceed, counsel person.
Thank you, my lord. My lord, my client, Mr. Kapoor, was arrested in 1991 in the charges of murder of his wife. He was supposed to get detention in the year 2006, but claiming that he was mentally insane, the state government and the jail authorities kept him in the jail since 2020. Like, he was released in 2020, October. It was almost approximately the double of his punishment he was given. So under the Article 21 and 20, we have filed a case against in the section of fundamental rights. He has been, his fundamental rights has been brutally affected because of this harassment or you can say in the jail. The government claims to be mentally that he was mentally insane, but provides no such proofs to prove that he was actually mentally insane. And they have no medical reports or no prescriptions or records of medicines given by doctor to prove that he was mentally insane. Under the Article 21, the Indian Constitution states that no one has the right to take out the living rights, the fundamental rights from a person until some specific cases mentioned in Constitution. Article 20 says that until, like, no one should kept in prison for more than the time that the court says. So, okay, sir. As his payment or process for his illegal detention in the jail, like, the about this double jeopardy, the case of double jeopardy, which is projected in front of the court by Article 22, which means that giving extra punishment even after his punishment was over illegally, that caused him many mental and physical troubles during this time. So we would ask in front of the court to give him monetary compensation as the refunding of his losses. Now I would like to ask Swarangi to continue further.
Sure.
Yes, sir. My lord, may I please proceed?
Yeah, permission granted.
Thank you. So the basic issue that arises here is whether keeping the appellant imprisoned even after his term was completed, even after his sentence was served, was that justified on the part of the state government when they did not even have the courtesy to present the medical records of my client actually being mentally unsound. So I would like to say that since the records were not exactly presented in any form, that the claim is false. It was a gross violation, a breach of his fundamental right to life, which has caused him immense injury. He even faced taboo from the society. He lost all of the reputation that he had built prior to his wife's death. So I would say that it is very unfortunate that he was kept imprisoned even after he had completed the whole jail term. And I would like to add to my friend's, Ms. Bhakti's claim that he should be given monetary compensation. Even though no monetary compensation can actually compensate for the injury that has been caused to his life. Further, I would say that it was completely unjustified on the part of the state government to keep him imprisoned even after he had done so much of work in jail, work on himself, work on his character. So I say that that my client deserves some sort of remedy from the state. Yes.
Point, counsel person. Now, council person, would you like to?
Sir.
Yeah. Yeah, please go ahead.
Sir, I would like to add a point that it's highly suspicious that even after the Session Court of Muzaffarabad given the order for his detention to the state government, and again after state government's claim that he was mentally insane without any proper look or without any proper evidence, they accepted it and they given the permission to sustain his detention until the state government gives next order. So it's highly suspicious or can be predicted that the person like my client would have some personal issues, some sort of like personal issues from anyone in this case involved. Sir, also it can be like, even if the court passed order and even if he was mentally insane, if we agree on this point, after he was stable, after his mental condition was stable, it was jail authority's duty to send a note for his detention, send an application for his detention to the state government or the session courts of Muzaffarabad respectively. So it can be said like the authorities, jail authorities neglected it or taken it as a careless attitude to do such work. Or the government or the court was having the careless attitude towards this case, because of which he suffered for almost twice of the punishment.
So, Counsel Fawson, would you like to add more?
Yes, my lord. I would like to add that the procedure established by Section 338 of the CRPC was not followed. If they claimed that he was indeed mentally unstable, then why was the procedure established by Section 338 of the CRPC not followed? Why was he just kept in jail without any further proceeding on his mental state? Why was he just kept in jail without any action taken to improve his mental health, or without any further documentation of it? To me, this seems like just a careless breach of fundamental rights by the state of Bihar, which they would have to compensate for. That's my issue.
Fine. Anything else, council person?
I would.
Yeah, please.
Yes, sir. I would like to add one more point, that even if he was mentally insane, then it makes sense nowhere to keep him in the jail. It was the duty to shift him in any mental hospital under the government's guidance or under the government's care. Because in criminal cases, they are not allowed to hand them over to their relatives if they are mentally insane, because it's not safe for them. So in this case, they were supposed to shift them in any mental hospital.
Great. So now, council persons, would you like to proceed with your prayers?
Yes, my lord. So I would like to add in my prayer that since the state of Bihar has caused grave loss of grave injury to my client's mental state and his physical life, I would say that he should be, I would request the court to remedy that by giving him monetary compensation for the breach of his life and personal liberty. Yes, sir.
Okay. Anything else you want to add in your prayer?
Sir, as in Mallika Gandhi case, we studied that like Article 21, when if any case affects Article 21, it also affects Article 14 and 19, as just living or the right to life does not only includes your existence, but includes your life with a human dignity. If you affect Article 21, if you affect someone's right to live, you indirectly or directly affect their life, their freedom to speech, or their equal rights in the society as of the others. So I would ask in my prayer to charge the government or the jail authorities punishments for these exceptions.
Thank you, council members. Now, just would like to ask you a couple of questions. So who would like to respond first?
My lord, I'll go ahead. I'll go ahead first.
Okay, great. So, what do you think is this is the fault of Muzaffarabad? Like, you know, like already the council person mentioned about the Muzaffarabad, what happened actually. Okay, so do you think like it's happened due to the Muzaffarabad incident? The civil surgeon Muzaffarabad reported that the accused Mr. Kapoor was, you know, normal, and his just a second information was, you know, given to the department, which was actually ignored. Okay, so when it was ignored, so do you think, I guess it's 100% responsibility of Muzaffarabad jail, or it should be like, you know, superintendent should have, you know, taken some action at that time?
Yes, my lord, the superintendent should have definitely taken some kind of action to actually put his acquittal into effect, put my client's acquittal into effect. I wouldn't say that it is entirely the jail's fault. I feel like it is a systematic problem that we face in the state of Bihar that has got to my client, that has affected my client particularly. So yeah, it was the state's fault. It was the government's fault. Everybody had an equal role to play in the kind of injury that has been caused to my client.
Okay, fine. So can you just repeat once again, like, how much compensation actually you're demanding, which is there, but can you just once again tell me? It's already mentioned in your memorial.
Yes, my lord. Yes, we would be demanding rupees 1 lakh as the compensation, which is not really a big amount, but it is not a big amount, but neither is it enough to compensate for the kind of injury that my.
So that's why actually I wanted you to repeat it, because do you think 1 lakh is sufficient for him?
May I go ahead?
Yeah, please.
1 lakh would be monetarily sufficient for him to go on with his life for a short period of time, but it is definitely not sufficient for to compensate for the kind of loss of life he has faced.
Okay. Great. So now another question is, I want to know, like, Article 32 and 21, how much it is relevant to this case law?
Sir, Article 21 is the most affected article in this case, as it's directly related to the right to life, because if any criminal has completed his punishment or has tenure in the jail, then he is not supposed to be anymore in the jail. Like, government or anyone does not have that right to take out his fundamental rights from him and forcefully keep him in the jail without any reason. Article 32 allows us to imply the habeas corpus writ in the case law so that the applicant or the victim of the crime should receive any compensation or any repayment of the losses he gained. That's why Article 32 and 21 are the most relevant articles in this case.
Okay. So, just a second. I'm just checking your memorial once again. And it sure is this here in your memorial that. Monetary compensation that we have discussed on, you know. Okay, and personal leverage. Fine. So you've covered all these. That's great. Okay. So do you think after release, like, Mr. Kapoor can have a better life with this compensation and, you know.
Sir, I think. Sir, I think that even in today's time, 1 lakh will not be enough for him. Like, it's not easy to come out of from jail after 30 years and get settled or get mixed with the environment that it's changed overall. Like, you can't be adjusted in a different environment that you suddenly are facing. That after 30 years of a gap between the world and you. So it will not be very easy for him. But if the honorable court and the honorable state government cooperated with the person to be settled, like allowed him to gain his fundamental rights back, then it would be a slightly easier for him to adjust with the environment around.
Fine. Thanks so much.